for a headlines today investigation. The recent case of rape of two minor girls at an unregistered orphanage in Pollachi town near Coimbatore has come as a wake-up call to the state that houses a large number of such illegal homes. My colleague Priyam Vada brings us this shocking report on the state of affairs at these homes.
The news of rape of two minor girls at this unrecognized children's home in Pollachi town near Coimbatore last week shocked the country, abducted by two men. They were raped and left to bleed. What was shocking is that this illegal home run by the Tamil Evangelical Lutheran Church or TELC had been functioning even as the social welfare department looked the other way. Believe it or not, the Tamil Nadu government knows precisely what the problem is. According to its records, of the 1,661 homes in the state, 320 are unrecognized, and most of them havens for abuse, ill treatment, and in a shoddy state of affairs. A fortnight back, a 15-year-old boy, an inmate of Freedom's Children's Home in Kanchipuram, fell into this open well and died. This despite the Juvenile Justice Act clearly stating that children's homes should follow all safety regulations.
Minutes of a meeting of Tamil Nadu government's Coordination Committee on Prevention of Human Trafficking, chaired by Chief Secretary in August 2010, state all unregistered children's homes should be inspected and closed by 31st October 2010.
According to the Juvenile Justice Act, all certificates issued in 2005 have expired and a fresh registration should have been obtained in 2010. But does anyone care for an official stamp of approval? Not Reverend Wilson, founder of the New Hope and New Life Home for Children in Medavakkam near Chennai.
Have you registered the home?
Under the KJ.
Can you cut something in a KJ?
If the law is flouted with impunity at the unregistered homes, the situation is no better at the ones that are registered. Like this one, run by Udhavam Ullam near Chennai. This place is home to 160 children, many of whom have developed skin diseases and are sharing space with mentally challenged persons. An asbestos sheet serves as the roof and the children have to do all the work. Child rights activists say that greedy NGOs with an eye on foreign funds open these homes, with care for the children not top on the priority list. Padam Narayanan filed a petition in the Madras High Court in 2012 to inspect these unregistered homes.
There are about 75% of the homes are homes which use this opportunity to get solicit foreign funds as well as funds from the government as well as from local investors, and they are run unnecessarily, and they bring children from poor families, most of them Dalits, and keep them within their homes and provide them very poor infrastructure as well as care and protection. Regular reports of sexual abuses and physical torture and all that in such NGO homes.
The social welfare department, responsible for the proper running of these homes, refused to comment on camera. Officials maintain that coordination between police and child welfare committee is a problem and have no answer for the manner in which these children are at risk.
We are working very proactive despite the meager resources at our command, and we have been doing excellent work in identifying all the children homes which do not conform to the norms prescribed by the ICPS as well as the Juvenile Justice Act. Yet blaming us is not fair.
There are over 3 lakh children at institutions in Tamil Nadu and are hardly taken care of. These children, who are the future of this country, are left to rot not just without care but also at risk. Every incident of abuse is a wake-up call, but officials do not seem to take notice. With camera person Daniel, this is Priyam Vada in Chennai for Headlines Today.
Joining me now from Bangalore is Anita Kanaya, Project Director of the Freedom Project. Ma'am, thank you very much for joining us on Up South. Now, it seems absolutely shocking that the Tamil Nadu government is completely unaware of what is happening on the ground. They even have the number of the unregistered orphanages. What does it really say about the system? What's really going on?
I think the system is has really got no monitoring in place. So while the government may know and may understand that children are being treated badly, I don't think they have the manpower to monitor every single institution. And even if they are, I don't think systems are in place for the institutions to be accountable for the kind of quality of care that they provide, or for the number of children, or the kind of children and the state in which the children are. I think both sides have something to say about this. And if we have to address this, I think we have to put monitoring systems in place and set good accountability for both sides.
Ms. Kanaya, one child rights activist here in Andhra Pradesh said that these are grounds of abuse and trafficking, many of these orphanages. Do you concur that perhaps there is a major racket going on in the garb of these orphanages?
I don't think we can say that all orphanages are like this, but there are definitely some places where they are fronts or they serve as orphanages, but really they are they're involved in some illegal activities where they house children for the wrong purposes, either for illegal adoptions or for child pornography and the child sex industry. We have done a rescue in the past where the children were headed to an orphanage in Goa, and they had no idea, the person on the other side had no idea. So they were definitely going to end up in some kind of a place. So yes, orphanages sometimes are fronts, especially when they're not monitored, when they are illegally registered or not registered, or they house too many children and are involved in some nefarious activities.
Right. Ms. Anita Kanaya, Project Director of the Freedom Project in Bangalore, thanks a lot for joining us with that perspective. In fact, it's not a problem limited only to Tamil Nadu. Even in Kerala, in fact, last month, more than 570 children from Bihar and Jharkhand were detained because they were accused, it was alleged that they were being illegally trafficked to orphanages there in Kerala. And now the Kerala government has decided to crack the whip. They have decided to set up an online system to monitor all orphanages in Kerala. Joining me now is my colleague Rohini Swamy from Kochi. Give us the details about how the Kerala government plans to actually do this.
Well, after the shocking incident where 456 children were illegally transported to Kerala from Bihar, West Bengal and Jharkhand came to light, which headlines today also reported, now the Kerala government has finally woken up. Now we are seeing it in two aspects. One is that they're empowering the Criminal Act. Secondly, they're maintaining an online register, an MIS of all the orphanages in Kerala. This is important because every child who will be brought to the orphanage, the Kerala government has said, should be educated, and the child's admission to the orphanage, the child when he or she leaves from the orphanage, everything should be recorded. Not just that, the marks of the child also should be recorded. This is important because finally the Kerala government has woken up. And also, it is also important to notice that if these things are put in place, then the government can also keep a close watch on the orphanages and what possibly there could be wrongdoings there.